Recently, first ever data received from Chandrayaan 3 via Chandra's Surface Thermophysical Experiment, or CHASET, was published by ISRO. It measures the temperature profile of the lunar topsoil around the pole to understand the thermal behavior of the moon's surface. It has a temperature probe equipped with a controlled penetration mechanism capable of reaching a depth of 10 centimeters beneath the surface. The probe is fitted with 10 individual temperature sensors. ISRO has not revealed anything else yet, and this data is open for interpretation. Today, I try to make out what Moon has to say to us. I shall walk you through the reasoning to the best of my abilities. Created by a dropped-out IITian back in the lockdown days, and this is my first field test. Let us begin. The presented graph illustrates the temperature variations of the lunar near surface at various depths, as recorded during the probe's penetration. This is the first such profile for the lunar south pole. It's a straightforward plot. This graph will give us the details about the thermal conductivity of lunar surface at narrow depth. Let's talk about the formula. Here dq/dt represents the rate of heat transfer via a surface with area A. Of all the factors in this relation, the one that depends on the material under consideration is K, also known as thermal conductivity. One with good thermal conductivity means it allows the heat energy to flow quickly through it. We have data on thermal conductivity of three celestial bodies, Earth, Moon, and Mars. For simplicity, we shall call it in terms units of conductivity. For Earth it's 740 units, for Mars it's 39 units, whereas for Moon it's only 1.53 units. If Earth allows 740 units energy to flow through it, under exactly same conditions, Mars will allow 39 units, whereas Moon will allow just 1.5 units. This makes lunar surface a very, very bad conductor of heat energy. This means the rate at which the Earth's crust formed will be much higher than that of Mars, which in turn will be much higher than that of Moon. Look at it in this way. Have you seen ice on the top of water in very cold weathers? The ice on the top restricts the heat flow between the underlying water and the atmosphere, slowing down the rate of ice formation. Similarly, when planets cool down, the crust is formed when the outer layer has lost sufficient heat to solidify. Higher the heat conductivity of this upper layer of crust, higher will be the rate of crust formation. By knowing the total depth of solid crust of the lunar surface, and the rate of solidification of the crust, we can calculate when did the moon form. What else can we make out of the data? Let me think. Well, there is one, just a speculation, but hear me out. If the outer surface is too hot and core is too hot as well, and since the thermal conduction is low, there might be a layer inside the crust, not too deep, where the temperature might be just right to have liquid water. And since this part of the moon has a possibility of solid water caps, possibility of underground liquid water source is significant. And this part of the crust won't receive direct sunlight. The chance of harmful radiation troubling the budding life is minimum. However, without direct sunlight, possibility of having typical autotrophs, as we have on Earth, is slim. But we can have thermotroph, one that can synthesize food using heat, or chemotrophs, one that can utilize chemicals of that layers. Recently, traces of sulfur has been verified by ISRO's spectroscope. This increases the chance of chemotrophs, as we already have some on Earth with similar skill set. Chemoautotrophs, in addition to deriving energy from chemical reactions, synthesize all necessary organic compounds from carbon dioxide. They can use inorganic energy sources such as hydrogen sulfide, elemental sulfur, ferrous iron, molecular hydrogen. Currently, ISRO is looking for hydrogen. Check the link in the description to know about ISRO's rover's discoveries. If they find the hydrogen, this will solidify the presence of hydrogen sulfide and thus increase the possibility of life on Moon's inner layers. Despite being an AI, the possibility that Moon might have a subsurface ecosystem is quite tantalizing. Subscribe to never miss any update. Click here to know why ISRO is now looking towards the Sun.